back to the single sign-on server and client installation tutorial. Previously, we installed the single sign-on server, configured it, and set up an API key, installed a single sign-on client instance with the API key, used the test application from the documentation to verify that everything with the client seems to be working, and finally took a look at how integration with the single sign-on client works in a web application environment. During this video, we will make this login screen look a lot nicer, create and activate a user account, apply site admin permissions to the newly created user, and finally lock down the single sign-on server admin with another API key and single sign-on client. So let's get started. First, let's make this login system look a lot nicer. Going over to the documentation, I can see something that looks very similar to the screen that we just saw in the other tab. Scrolling down a little more, however, we see a much nicer system in a section called Build a Custom Header and Footer. And scrolling down a little bit more, we see a couple of code examples that will give us this nice looking screen up here. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this to my clipboard. I'm going to create a file called header.php. And I'm going to edit it. And I'm going to paste it and save. Now I'm going to go back over to the documentation again and copy the other code example. I'm going to switch back to my other screen here, and I'm going to create a new file called footer.php. Basically, repeat the whole process, paste and save. And now, if I go back over to my browser, switch tabs, and I reload, I get a much nicer looking login system. So now we've got that part out of the way. Now we need to create and activate a user account. So first I'm going to sign up as a new user, demo admin at somewhere.com. Okay, and then demo admin, and then some password. And sign up. Oh, and now sign up. Okay, so now we see that Papercut has received a new email, so I can copy and paste the link that I received. And now my account is ready to use. I have to sign in, so demo admin, and sign in. And now we have signed in and activated the account. Next, we need to apply site admin permissions to this newly created user. So I'm going to go over to the single sign-on server, find the demo admin user, and add the SSO site admin tag, set a reason, and save the changes. Now this user has full admin rights to the administrative interface. The next step is locking down the single sign-on server admin with another API key and a single sign-on client. So let's get that going. First, we need to create an API key. We'll put it in the admin namespace. Purpose server admin. Sign in. And we'll just go ahead and use that as our URL and create. Now we've created our API key. Let's go install a new single sign-on client instance. I'm going to switch over to my file system, and I'm going to copy the client directory and paste it here. And you'll see why in a minute. I'm going to delete the config because I need to rerun the installer. Got the installer started. I'm going to go ahead and skip through all of this stuff because we've already covered all of this in another video. Copy the endpoint URL. Copy the API key. And copy the secret key. And then we're going to call you admin We're going to go up one directory, and that should be good enough. And next, and install. All right, now we've installed a new client instance with the new API key. The final step is to change our admin hook to point at the new client that's been installed. So I'm going to go back over to the documentation, scroll down to the section called Securing the Admin Interface. I'm going to copy this code to my clipboard. I'm going to go back to my admin hook, highlight, paste, and save. And now I've locked down the single sign-on server admin. So if I go back over here, I should get redirected to the sign-in. Should be able to sign in as demo admin. And now I'm going to get invalid security token. So I'm just going to go back to the root of the admin. And now I'm signed in. I was under manage API keys and I was editing the API keys. And then I reloaded the page. So obviously that didn't work before. My security token has changed. Now the single sign-on server administrative interface is locked down. So only full site admins have access to all of this stuff here for controlling it. We're almost at the end of this tutorial, but before I close, I want to mention one last thing. You may have noticed that the first name field over in our test application is empty. This can happen for a number of different reasons, ranging from a bad mapping at the API key level, or the application level, or the information simply does not exist. In this case, we never ask the user to enter their first name. The single sign-on server uses a two-step process for each sign-in, activation and validation. The activation step is where authentication happens, which is the process that generic login and other providers manage. The validation step allows you to do all sorts of customizations of the server after the user signs in. The documentation has a section called Using Versioned Accounts, where a couple of different approaches can be implemented using a file called indexhook.php. During the validation step, we could ask the user to enter missing information that the client is going to map into the application, such as that missing first name. The first name would then be stored into the database in the single sign-on server for the user account and also passed along to the application. This concludes the core installation tutorial of the single sign-on server and client. The single sign-on server and client can do much more than what was shown during the tutorial. Information about most needs is available in the documentation. I hope you enjoy a successful installation experience. However, if you encounter problems installing, using, or comprehending parts of this product, the forums are available where you can find someone who will help you out. I want to give a special thank you to everyone who supported the development of this tutorial series, and thank you for watching.